Hi guys, it's Alona
and Sana,
and today we wanted to talk to you about senior scams. It's something that's very sad, but unfortunately is going on a lot right now, and a lot of your loved ones may be getting the panicked phone calls or whatever it is, so I think to educate them and let them know what's happening is really, really important, and Sana will tell you about some of the scams that we saw firsthand our seniors falling for.
Yeah, so a couple tips you're going to want to give your elderly loved ones based on what we've seen. Never give out your social security number. I witnessed in a woman, somebody called her and said that she won something, and the only way that she could get her prize is if she handed over her social security number and her credit card number. And if I had not walked in at that exact moment, she was ready to give it to them because she was so excited to win this prize. And she was an intelligent woman, but they just, like, the way they worded it, they just convinced her. And she even asked them questions like, are you real? What's this? Give me details. And she just, they're really good at it. Yeah. They're professionals. And she was about to fall for it. Another one that we've seen a lot is they'll call you in the middle of the night and tell you that your grandson needs to be bailed out of jail or bailed out of trouble and you need to wire $50,000 immediately. We have seen people try to go to the bank and withdraw $50,000 to hand over to these people. This is not okay. You need to talk to your parents about the fact that in that moment, let's think about it. Maybe call me if you get a phone call like that.
Yeah.
We can try to figure it out because half the time, your grandson is probably sleeping in his bed. So you can tell them, hey, I know if this something like this happens, I know you're scared, but make sure you call me first or let's call the police. Let's try to figure this out because that's really scary. People have lost their entire life savings over scams like this. And then lastly, just, I know it seems so obvious, but just talking to them again about not letting strangers into their home.
Yeah.
Some seniors are very already like that. They don't trust anybody and they don't want anybody near them. They don't want anyone in their home. Other seniors we've seen are really trusting because when they grew up, you didn't have to lock your doors. You could send your kid down the street and he could come back 8 hours later. They kind of grew up in a time where things were safer. So maybe if they, whether they have dementia or not, whether they're kind of used to that, they might not think anything of it. But big no-no. I don't care how nice they seem. I don't care if it's just like a sweet-looking young man. You want to remind them never to let anyone into their home. And definitely make sure they keep their credit cards to a minimum so that they have less of a risk of having their credit card stolen or their identity stolen. So it's so unfortunate that people go after the elderly, but there's a reason why, because they fall for it sometimes.
Yeah, they're definitely the target right now, and it's sad, and so it's something that we just have to prepare for and fight against and the world we live in now.
Yeah, so have that talk with them and just reassure them if they're ever confused on what to do to call you. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.